All right, cool. What are we doing this week?
Gary, take these scissors.
I'm not going to take scissors.
Yeah, scissors are valuable in this post-scissor future.
They're just fun.
We reached peak lube, and now all the scissors got rusty.
Yeah, exactly. We used all the lube on our beaters. What do we do for our scissors? Not my problem, Beyond.
You question the wisdom of the lube ration.
Yes, and now you may snip in silence. All of your coupons will end up ragged at the edge. So says Crick.
For your folly. Anyway, so I want you to take these scissors and run as fast as you can over to that corner of the room.
Done and done.
Okay, cool. Now cut that string.
Okay, good.
Okay, here we go. All right. Okay, cool. So the toy car that's going down the track, cool. That knocked over the bowling ball, and that is hitting the catapult, which is launching up the toy army man, which is hitting the balloon, which is popping that and disturbing the small elf.
Are we in an Okay Go video?
Damn it, Gary. You ruined the take. We're going to have to start this again. Gary, take these scissors.
Okay,
run over to that corner.
Okay.
I need you to cut that string. Okay, the toy car has gone down the ramp. I forget, it's knocked over the bowling ball, which has startled the elf, which has raised the balloon, which has scattered the army men, has opened up this Steam copy. This is a confetti of codes to download Bad Rats.
Oh, we haven't talked about this before we do this. I like this game a lot.
Fuck yes.
Yeah, fuck yeah. I actually think this is really good.
Yep.
And like, in the way that if the end of the time I played it, if I'm asking myself, like, am I enjoying this?
Uh-huh.
Like, yes, I'm having a lot of fun with this.
Yeah, this is, okay, so it's on a different scale. It's on a different scale, but this is the deadly premonition effect for me.
Oh, yeah.
Right?
Yeah, I could see that a little bit.
Yeah, like you couldn't make a justifiable case for this, like, you know, just because, you know, it's mostly the trappings, right? It's mostly the trappings and just the technical sloppiness, but the whole of the experience is something that, like, adds up to, you know, more than the sum of the parts.
Yes. I am Gary Butterfield.
I am Cole Ross.
And this is Abject Suffering. Thanks for doing this. And this episode, we're talking about Bad Rats.
Yeah, Bad Rats. The Rat's Revenge.
Yeah, by Invent4 Entertainment. Is it a company that I'm going to go ahead and say is probably not based in the United States?
Probably not, no. Yeah, was that the developer or the publisher? Because I have a French-Canadian a company here called Strategy First.
I don't know which one it is, as
the company that put this out.
Which, I couldn't find a Wikipedia. I just kind of Googled around.
Yeah. So this is on that page, but like that's the same company that they did like Jagged Alliance. So I'm not quite sure.
Oh, that makes a weird kind of. Well, yeah, I don't know because Jagged Alliance is good.
Yeah, it's well known. Like or well, yeah. You know, it is well thought of at the very least.
Technically good.
Yeah.
I've known about this game for a long time because there is a something awful goon group called, I think they call themselves the Rat Kings, which are people who got all the achievements in this. And Nick Glauber of Check It Out Comrade is one of them. And he's like, I would see him playing Bad Rats. I was like, Bad Rats? What the fuck are you doing, dude? And then he would tell me, he's like, no, it's, get this, it's like the Incredible Machine, but the physics aren't consistent. So, and then I was like, well, that doesn't seem so.
Okay.
Like, now I get why that's a problem. You know, oh, you mean when you do something twice, it doesn't happen the same way.
Huh.
So all of your sense of experimentation.
Yeah. So the trial and error, it's trial, then error, sub two, error, sub three, error, sub four, like that. Yeah. Okay, cool.
Yeah. And then there's not as much correlation to your trial to your success.
Yeah.
as you might expect.
Yeah, which also leads to these situations where, you know, Incredible Machine, you build and you see you get the like partway to the gold and you think, okay, cool, let me refactor, get a little bit further. You can just knock it out of the park by complete chance in this one too.
Or if you something fails and you get kind of close, mm-hmm. just try it a couple more times and it'll probably work.
Yep, and you get like a bunch of points for it.
How weird is that? Yeah, it is just a weird choice. And I think that part, you know what I think it is that for some reason the game is in 3D. It's like presented as 2D, but actually exists in 3D because mm-hmm. that's easier to make.
Yeah.
So these things, the variants, you're getting yaw mm-hmm. that's being accounted for that's fucking everything up. Like several times I'd do something and my ball would float into the foreground. And I was like, what's in the foreground?
Well, so like what? So what's weird about that is, and so I did this a couple times too, it's after a certain number of bounces or interactions that it doesn't go anywhere, that it'll like roll into the foreground in order to force a reset.
Mm.
Yeah. So elements will go into the foreground as like a failsafe so that it doesn't just like, you know, judder around.
It really felt like, I mean, this could be, I only played for about twice as long as we usually play for these games. But it felt like it happened to me sooner than that, or on more frequently than that, or earlier in the level. But I could be wrong.
Yeah.
So it is essentially like a very limited version. Like you should play it on expert, start out on expert, mm-hmm. because you just have a goal and you get all the tools to make it. And it's like a little bit like the Incredible Machine or Lemmings, mm-hmm. where you're just setting up different physics objects and starting a machine to go. To try to kill this cat.
Yeah. So easy mode or tutorial mode or whatever. Not fun because it gives you like a blueprint in the background. Mm-hmm. And just it holds your hand way too much.
Yeah.
So definitely start it at least on hard.
Yes.
Yeah. But I love how it's the same stuff every time. You have a ball that you're trying to use to hit some kind of an implement of death in order to kill this cat, this poor cat, in like an incredibly grotesque way every time. Like this is the Itchy and Scratchy game. Like, let's just reskin this with Itchy and Scratchy and you'd be fine.
Yeah, it is. It is really, really like comic mischief-y gore, you know,
like with eyes and brains and blood
and
splatter that,
and
that hits
and
the
stuff.
Yeah, microwave cat skeletons. Yeah,
yeah. Oh, yeah. I mean, that kind of goes in general. We have to talk about the theming a little bit.
Yeah,
in this game,
which is absolutely grotesque, horrific, off-putting theming.
Yeah, just like everything is so poorly designed and considered mm-hmm. and gross looking. Like they're just, it's very, very bad. Bad assets is what they should have called this. It is everything looks just like repulsive, like and cheap, like cell phone mascots. Like everything looks like a Qualcomm alien. You know?
Yeah. Well, there's a sponsored version where you're having to you have to get the ball towards the card that has prepaid phone minutes.
Yeah. Yeah, and you have to achieve blue status, blue rats. But the other thing that happens in the framing or the theming is that you have your lemmings. You have a little lemming that blows up. And how do they portray that? Well, lemmings wear a cute shirt and they've got a bomb on it.
Mm-hmm.
It's pretty cute.
Yeah.
Here, straight up like Islamic stereotype suicide bombers.
Yeah.
What are you doing, bad rats? Like, how did nobody tell you that wasn't a good idea?
Yeah, that's real, real gross. And there's no excuse. So like this, the reason that this is so kind of like ubiquitous in a lot of people's minds is the canonical bad, PC game is because this was one of the first games to actually get on Steam outside of a Half-Life game. Right. Mm. I only say that not just to say like, this is why everybody has it because it's always on sale for 25 cents, but it's more to say they should have known better by the time. They should have known better by 2005. And that leads me to believe that's probably, it's another, you know, nail in the coffin of like, yes, this definitely was not developed in the United States because for as like, for as much as we allow Jeff Dunham to stay alive, like I can't imagine this flying in a video game for some reason.
It is. Like it's not like you can't, it's not like just this innocent thing. Like they pray and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Like they look offended. Like if you drew that rat in class, you'd be sent to the principal's office.
Yeah.
Like it is not okay.
And he's alongside like such innocuous stuff. Like, oh, here's a little evil Knievel guy who's shot out of a cannon, or here's a little baseball, you know, a little baseball rat. you know, that I think shouts hit or swing every time he swings.
See, he swings something. He says something. I don't know. A lot of the people in the reviews bought this game for 24 cents to farm it for Steam trading cards.
Jesus.
To sell, which is sad and weird to me.
The guy. Okay. So I think the guy who designed that system is now in charge of Greece's economy.
Yeah. Like, who is this? So I'm looking at the reviews now. So Katawa Shoju His Life wrote a negative review complaining about it. That is wrong. Like, so first of all, negative review, 10.4 hours on record. So who fucked up?
Okay, fool me once, shame on you. Fool me 10.4 times.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, and then also I realize I feel bad because I'm going to keep reading. I think the review is like a joke review.
No.
Because he said it, like one of the things I just picked up is like amazing graphics. I was like, this guy actually likes these graphics, but no, he's just being trying to be jokey.
Yeah. Yeah. He's doing.
So never mind. I take it back.
He is being ironic.
Yeah. Good job. Yeah. You sure fooled somebody into thinking you didn't like what you did like. Yeah. Good job.
Yes, that is an achievement. Yeah. Oh, Gary, I missed an opportunity in the previous episode when we were talking about Dracula. The one fact for the
Bad
Genesis
Ratula?
Version. Yes, Bad Ratula. The one fact for the Genesis version. It says Bram Stoker Dracula. And then it credits the ASCII art. To Vinheim 2009. So,
pretty cool.
Yep, so it's not just a misspelling, Bram Stoker, which is, I think, everybody's intro level to a horror-themed porn. It is misspelled ASCII art. Back to the matter at hand. I just wanted to make sure that got out there. I have
back
no self-control. Back to the rat.
Back to these rats. The other reason why I'm sure that their country of origin is not an English-speaking one is because of the tutorial messages that happen between each level, which are amazing.
Mm-hmm.
Like, they're just like, okay, we know the ball can hit the microwave button, fine. But the hint section is like, you know, Rocket Rat can be used to good effect on ramp, even level ramp.
Mm-hmm.
Like, there are these weird broken English sentences that are really great.
The board can make the path lacking. This is all about pushing the ball sidelong.
Yeah, sidelong. Yep. Like, one tip is to use sidelong balls. Like, what are you talking about?
My doctor fixed my sidelong balls.
Lacking. Yeah. There's all aching.
Like, wait, can you remind me of where There's All Aching came from?
It's from my review with Forrest McNeil, the Annie Daly TV show, where the real Lisa King comes in and they mix it up.
Oh, he goes just crazy. Yeah, that's why I know this, because he told me this story.
Yeah, probably on this show. You should watch Review. Review's really good. There's only 8 episodes. And it probably is not going to come back, which is a bummer. It was really good. That show gets dark.
He loses his mind because of There Is All Aching, right?
Well, he's also the season-long plot is his marriage falling apart because of his dedication to the show.
Oh, yeah?
And it is just the saddest thing. Like, he is such a pathetic, well-meaning goober.
Mm-hmm. Your goal is make the ball hit the vault.
Yeah,
like,
yeah,
this isn't English as a second language. This is English as a vague concept that they heard whispered of once.
Yeah, like English through like a series of telephone, mm-hmm. like the game telephone conversations. Mm-hmm. Like it is really special.
Yeah.
But at the end of the day, like it is fun. This is a fun genre. Mm-hmm. This doesn't, unlike The Incredible Machine or something like that, like this doesn't have too many pieces as to be like, you know, there's nothing that like does the same thing as another piece, but just subtly different,
mm-hmm.
which is what always happens when I try to play one of those games where it's like, oh, okay, this is, you know, this thing blows it at this speed, but this thing blows it at this speed. And you have to like figure out there's just too much like trial and error down to that little micro level.
Mm-hmm. Or like way too complicated of like a sense of attachment. Like, everybody's talking about how awesome Besieged is, and I've downloaded it and tried it, but it definitely has that problem in spades of you know, not sufficiently differentiated parts.
Yeah. And that is a bummer. Whereas this is like just simple enough. And like when I was playing it, I was like, I'm feeling real feelings of satisfaction when I kill this cat. you know, I'm actually having fun watching this stuff kind of like, once you kind of, and you can, when you do the freestyle mode, you have all the tools from the beginning. So you can do needlessly complex machines.
Mm-hmm.
It affects your score and it may stop me from being a rat king or getting into the rat club or what have you. But it does, it's kind of fun to watch.
Mm-hmm.
Like, it's like, this, I was like, man, this is the most fun I've had, like, playing an Abject Suffering game in a really long time.
Yeah.
What are you doing to me, Bad Rats? Why can't I quit you?
Well, what's funny is, like, it's just a good genre.
Yeah.
Like, they try as hard as they can to fuck it up, or they try as little as possible to justify its existence, but it still ends up being satisfying.
That's what it is. It's like the other genres, like, you know, platformers are not inherently good.
Mm-hmm.
You know, like, the FPSs aren't inherently good. Like, this is just kind of, there aren't enough of these, and it's hard to fuck up.
Yeah.
To where it'll always be a little bit fun.
Mm-hmm.
So.
Yeah, I don't know. Like, this is the, I'm happy to hear you say that, because I was going to come in, and I thought I was going to be the weirdo who played too much Gizmos and Gadgets as a kid.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
No, I liked those games when I was young, too. I never, like I said, when I tried to go back to them, more modern mm-hmm. versions are slightly too complicated for me, yeah. which makes me sound like an idiot. But, like,
well, I mean,
it's the same way I can't play later SimCities. Like, yeah. I don't want to deal with water pipes.
Yeah. Well, I mean, it's like, Contraption Maker has a little bit of that problem, because
yeah.
it grew up with the audience and assumed that the audience had continued to play those and, like, want them to, you know, to evolve like that.
Whereas really, I just want a bite-sized, like, discrete level-by-level experience of that.
I feel the same way about liking this as I do about liking Bad Piggies.
What, remind me what Bad Piggies is?
Okay, so Bad Piggies, it's the spinoff of Angry Birds.
Oh, okay, I've seen Bad Piggies, but I never played it.
Yeah, so it's a little bit like Besieged, or, you know, kind of like this, where you're using parts to build a vehicle. In order mm-hmm. to move these piggies from, you know, like around these series of, you know, obstacles and things like that. And you have, you know, carts, and you have you're making airplanes and stuff. Like, it's really good. Like better than an Angry Birds spinoff ought to be.
I will go as far as to say that, like, Angry Birds isn't like a death march or anything either.
Oh, no.
Like, that game, there's some joy to be found in that game. It just become the poster child for, like, you know, there's no reason to sell lighters of it in truck stops, you know, like that shit's stupid, but, like, it's not so bad.
Yeah.
As a game, it can be kind of fun.
Yeah. Like, that is a situation where the random physics work against the fun of the game as opposed to for it. Like, I find Angry Birds incredibly frustrating because of the fact that doing the same thing multiple times gets you different results, because it's,
yeah.
It feels too chaotic for me in a way that doesn't feel like it's in service to what it's trying to get me to feel.
Yeah. Yeah. It's also, since they're oftentimes kind of freemium mm-hmm. and you can buy power-ups every time, like, something fucks up, it feels like, you know, it's somebody trying to get your money.
Yeah.
So it's a bummer. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Oh, so this is kind of crazy. They sold. Yeah. So they sold. They sold all of their. Okay, so this company went bankrupt, and they sold all of their catalog, right? The rights to all their games to Zoo Games, which I know because that is a game company that was based in the neighborhood where I currently live, here in Cincinnati. Like, and they made a whole bunch of, like, M&M's themed games. They made the Silly Bands game for DS.
I don't know what's going on.
Yeah, they did Capsized for Xbox Live. Like they were just super low rent shovelware publisher that was, like, stationed right next to, or their headquartered right next to, the GameStop that I worked at.
You should college. Go, like, get yourself some Bad Rats assets, dude. Like, just go hang out there and see if you can find, like, a Bad Rats plush or something. Could get Lung Rat.
Yeah, I couldn't figure out Lung Rat. What did he do?
He blows. He smokes, so he has good lungs.
That's mean. Like, be constructive. He doesn't just blow. Like, come on.
You know, he exhales at great volume because he smokes. So, like, because he smokes, he has good lungs.
Mm, he's a lunger, yeah.
Yeah, which, yeah, exactly. He's got black lungs. He's got rat lung. Yeah, I would, man, like, I want, like, a Bad Rats t-shirt or something like that. Like, I'm sure that this is, like, right on that edge of ironic bad,
mm-hmm.
to where, like, that there probably are people with cool Bad Rats t-shirts and shit, like,
mm-hmm.
you know, I'm not that original with this, but it does just seem pretty cool to me. I don't know.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you know? I'm down with it. This is a pleasant surprise insofar as I expected it. So this was suggested by Serg or Surge. He is a fixture on the Something Awful forum thread, which is very kind to us. And he was so kind as to actually gift us some Steam keys.
Yeah, for this. Which is awesome. Like, I weirdly didn't have this, mm-hmm. which I'm kind of surprised, but I did not.
Yeah.
Even though it's been 24 cents so many times, and I've actually heard about it being good from Nick. So
yeah, this is a little bit like this is one of those ones that has a reputation of being Steam fruitcake a little bit.
Yeah.
Like this this is the gift that people who do that will give as a like, haha, you were excited that you got a gift, but it turned out to be bad rats. It was exactly. Bad rats and a copy of The Ship, which is actually kind of good.
Yeah. Or Judge Dredd, Dredd versus Death.
Oh, yeah?
Which I had fun playing. Yeah, like, if you can get somebody to play with you. Like, it is only fun co-op, but mm-hmm. it is ridiculous. Mm-hmm. So there's an arresting mechanic I could never figure out where, like, you have to arrest people. Mm-hmm. And never seem to do anything, but you just have an arrest button for citizens. And they just instantly, in, like, two frames of animation, get on their knees and put on handcuffs.
Themselves? Like, oh, here, yeah. don't you bother. Let me do this.
Exactly. Yep. Pretty good.
Yeah. Yeah, I don't know. This I'm just curious because there's so many bad games on, like, games that at first glance appear to just be really bad on Steam. And this has caused me to kind of think that there might be more there, even though I kind of know that there isn't.
Yeah. Yeah, it is a hard, you know, trying to figure that out is tough. Mm-hmm. But I don't know, man. I like this game and everyone should play it. Mm-hmm. Everybody should check it out at least. If you're not, I mean, so if I put myself in the mindset that this was, I try not to do like a cost value thing with games very much, but like mm-hmm. if this was $5, I could see being bummed out.
Yeah.
But the fact that it's free, by not just free for us with Steam codes, but it's practically free for anyone because it's so frequently 24 cents. So everyone probably has it. Steam fruitcake, like you said, like, as well, I don't know. Well, here's your time. It's hard for me to be cynical about it.
here's the thing, though. Even on like on a regular day when it's not on sale, it's 99 cents. This is exactly. Steam as App Store.
Yeah.
Right?
Yep.
And it has a demo, for God's sake.
if you don't want to make the bad rat plunge. So weird.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Have you ever seen a rat in real life?
Yes, several times.
Yeah, you live in New York City.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So probably tons of rats.
Yeah, which, boy, oh boy, if you ever, if you're standing in like a subway station and you look across to a platform that just doesn't have any people on it, they'll just be out there like it's recess.
Yeah.
It's really, like you expect rats to stick to the corners, but if they have no fucks to give, that's number four today, then they will just cavort on the pavement out in the open in like not broad daylight, but the subway equivalent of broad daylight, flickering fluorescent light. Yeah.
Weird.
Yeah. Good rats. You know, just have like whatever. Like rats are smart. They're fine. They're, you know, the time has vindicated them. They were not the spreaders of the plague. I wouldn't mm-hmm. want one in my house. Although I told you I was subletting that apartment in New York, and I was there with my girlfriend, and she said that I saw something move out of the corner. I think you have rats or mice or something. Well, okay. Well, I'll put out a trap. I tried like non-lethal traps, but I turned to lethal traps because whatever, and mm-hmm. killed one. And then, you know, if you see one rat, it's like cockroaches. There are more. There's never just one. And I had 3 weeks left on that, so I was like, cool. I'm just going to buy a bunch of plastic bags for my food, get everything up on like the upper shelves, and we are just going to exist in an
uneasy. Just ride this out.
Yep, just ride this out because it's not going to be my problem for very long. And just going to sleep and hearing them skittering under the radiator baseboard.
Gross.
Yeah. Yep. I never found any droppings, so that also helped.
Yeah, that's at least nice.
Yeah. Have you? Rats?
Just outside. Like, I've never seen one indoors. Other than that, Derek, he was my roommate for a little while, and he had fancy rats as a pet. And when you get a pet rat, they're called fancy rats. If you go to Petco, they're called fancy rats.
I mean, do they have like little top hats?
Huh? Yeah, they're like the Mr. Peanut of rats. buy my kind and eat them by the handful. I don't know why they're called that, but they're cute. They're super cute. They always had huge balls. Like their balls compared to their body size is unreasonable. Like just and they would just constantly run on these little wheels, and it's just like these two twin
flip-da, flip-da, like, flip-da, flip-da, flip-da.
Twin water sacks just wrestling.
we had one of those motivational speakers in high school who came through. You know, he was on a circuit, like recovering alcoholic, telling us about how condoms don't stop the spread of AIDS. And he was asked to not come back because he told a story about sneaking up behind a rhinoceros and playing with his balls in order to agitate him at a zoo.
Who wins there? What are you risking? Yeah. Why?
Yeah, and he mimed it. Like, he just kind of, like he was daintily slapping, like, a hysterical person. It's like, flippity, flippity, flippity. It was a funny story. Like, obviously not true, I guess. But he was asked not to come back, specifically because of referring to playing with rhinoceros testicles.
That's weird.
Yep.
I hate genitals at the zoo.
Yeah.
Like, you ever see, like, it's like you're there and, like, an elephant, you know, peas or something like that,
mm-hmm.
like a lady elephant, and just like,
yep.
I don't care for that at all. Like, I don't.
Yeah, it's like somebody emptying their super soaker.
Yeah, it is just opening up one of those like change purses.
Yeah,
those little rubber.
Yeah,
like bank branded change purses, and mm-hmm. then just a bunch of pee coming out, like Morton Cadence and this decanter.
Yeah,
has just been opened up.
Yeah, spending so much time around like racehorses and stuff, you know, at the fairgrounds and things, or you know, actually at fairgrounds, not for events, just like with horses around. Yeah, horses are hard like all the time. It's really off-putting.
If I wasn't like mayor, but I was like a Mr. Mix Picklick kind mm-hmm. of character and could like just change reality. I wouldn't want animals not to have genitals. But hold on 1 second. I wouldn't want animals to not have genitals. My cat just did something stupid. That's the interruption. I wouldn't want animals not to have genitals, but I would want animals to wear like cartoon diapers all the time. Like, I think that would be cute and it would make cleanup a breeze. And like, you wouldn't have to see any, I never want to see an animal have an erection other than a human.
Yeah. Like, yeah, no, just it's an opportunity for corporate sponsorship too. You got underoos on there, like,
oh,
hey,
yeah,
that's so that, you know, here's an elephant with some DuPont underoos.
Do in the podcast,
here's a kangaroo.
We rename the entire animal to underoos. In your podcast circles, are people keep talking about fundies
like fundamentalist Christians?
No, it's an underwear company that makes like underwear.
What and the it's, fuck is going on? What the fuck is going on with podcasts? Because the one that I'm getting is MeUndies.
Oh, that, I think that's actually what I meant. I think that somebody said fundies as a joke. MeUndies is what I meant. I'm sorry.
Okay, yeah, like they're sweeping the nation.
The circuit, yeah.
Yeah, talking about how it wicks away moisture, which, you know, that's what I like. You know, I like the idea that my ball sweat is being wicked onto my jeans. That's why I fucking wear underwear, dog. I don't want ball sweat on my goddamn jeans. Don't wick me.
Yeah, just soak it up. Like, just tell me it's more absorbent. Yeah. I don't need a puddle. Like, at the end of the day, like, it just wicks it into like a hydrophobic pouch.
Hey, Cole, that's a weird hat you're wearing. Oh, it's a floor slippery sign. All my ball sweat is wicking onto the tile. Like, I'm down for like treating yourself and making sure you got your junk swaddled, but don't bring wicking principles into this shit.
It's a misguided advertisement.
Which it's fine. Like, buy your underwear online, get it, like, whatever. I'm down with ordering glasses online too, but it's weird.
It is weird. It sounds gross to me. Yeah. And it also, I enjoy a quality pair of underwear.
Yeah, I'm not a prude.
I've worn a pair of underwear and been like, this pair of underwear is worse than this other pair of underwear. This pair of underwear is better.
Yep. I've bought underwear and thought, this is no good, and because I've just thrown it away. Because it does not rise to my satisfaction, and they change them enough that you can't just do like I do with my t-shirts and get an Amazon subscription to them.
Yeah,
so
it is. Underwear are different enough, but the thing is that underwear will never be as good as MeUndies trying to make underwear sound.
Mm-hmm.
And that is what it's like. You know, it's. I mean, this is an old hacky. It's not hacky because it's not stand-up comedians don't say this kind of thing, but it could be where it's like that or like Sherry's Berries. Or something like that, where it's like, this is just a fucking strawberry, dude.
Mm-hmm.
It's $20 for 6 strawberries. Like, and it sucks because podcasts have that relationship where like you feel like you trust the person and you like the person and you're friends. Mm-hmm. And it's like, why is Paul Scheer trying to tell me $20 for 6 strawberries is worth it?
Mm-hmm.
He wouldn't do that. He's my buddy.
Yeah.
You know, probably, you know, Scott Aukerman knows that I don't care about loot crate.
Mm-hmm.
Like
loot crates, especially egregious.
Yeah. They're the worst.
Like,
yeah.
I don't know. Like there are podcast sponsors that I've tried and like genuinely like, mm-hmm. you know, like that is fine. I have learned about products and services, you know, usually from shows that are tailoring it to their audience. And yeah. the thing about those is when it pops up willy nilly and the McElroy brothers are telling me about, you know, MeUndies. Yeah. I just, yeah. It's super weird. And I understand that people have to be paid. It's super, you know, like that's fine. I understand it, but just the fact that they are doing what has been happening in talk radio for so long, which is co-opting a trusted voice, co-opting that intimacy in order to kind of get that get that extra deuce off at the top.
It feels way worse with a podcast.
Yeah,
because the intimacy is just stronger and like mm-hmm. I don't know.
Yeah, so
it's fucking loot, right?
Yeah,
there's a bunch of stuff you get for free if you went to PAX and you'd throw it away mm-hmm. in your hotel room. Like we've yeah. skimmed the garbage cans of hotel rooms yeah. around conventions.
And like I've done NatureBox.
Yeah.
Right? It's fine. Like I don't like, if I could get those sriracha roasted cashews elsewhere, I would probably buy them. It's not worth getting a $20 box that has like three tiny like snack bags or whatever. I will go to the store and just buy some nuts because that's what I want is nuts. But it's fine. Yeah. But the you know just don't get me started on like brand stories or whatever.
Yeah, it's gross.
Sorry.
It's okay. It's
you got me depressed.
No, it's okay. It's gross in a way that we'll just play some Bad Rats, pick yourself back up. Yeah, so remind me who suggested Bad Rats?
This was suggested by Sir, who I think is Sir Sapphire from the Something Awful forums.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Thanks, Sir.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. It was a good game. I like the Bad Rats.
Thank you for introducing me to something that I like. You know, it's one of those situations where when you fire up a game on Steam that you're not 100% proud of, mm-hmm. you know, like I'll play, you know, Long Live the Queen or something. Like people are kind of going to know that I'm playing this anime life sim, but it's pretty good.
I had, while playing this, somebody on Steam and forgive me for not remembering for not seeing who it was because I don't have the window open anymore. But it was like, is this an abject suffering preview or are you just torturing yourself? And I was like, yes and no. But I meant like yes to the first question, no to the second question, not, yeah. You know, both.
Mm-hmm. So I was downloading this and I saw that you were playing it. So mm-hmm. I was like, okay, cool. I can take refuge because if anybody's friends with both of us, they'll see that they're doing it and they can put two out. And two together.
Yeah. Man, I was just thinking about co-op Bad Rats. That's awesome. Does Bad Rats have like a level designer?
I hope.
Rat of shit? I don't think it does. I think for 24 cents, I think you've gotten all the value I can expect for 24 cents out of Bad Rats.
Yeah.
Can't even buy a pack of gum for 20 cents anymore.
Yeah.
Like, not to be like an old man talking about the value of a dollar, but like, that's such a good value.
Yeah, but you can't even buy a single gumball. You walk up to a gumball machine, it's got the two. What, you're waiting for two quarters gumball machine?
Yeah, that's ridiculous. Come on.
If it wasn't for the
Islamophobia that's rampant in this game, I would say like this is the best like value to dollar ratio game I played in a long time.
And I was about to say something crazy about the French because like you can kind of tell that it's French because of the way that it treats Islam. It's kind of gross.
Yeah. Anywho, thank you, Serge. Mm-hmm. What can they do if they want to help us out, Cole?
Well, iTunes ratings and reviews. We say that every time. If you kind of know somebody who listens to some of our other shows, I'm going beyond just like friends who might like this. Introduce them to stuff that's on topic first, and then kind of like say, okay, over here in this corner, we have something kind of different. But you know, I say it most times when I'm prompted to. This is some of the most fun that I personally have. Recording a show, and I want more people to find out about this thing. We've been growing, but we can always grow faster. So I think that word of mouth and helping spread the word is what's going to help us most.
Agreed.
Yeah.
Agreed and want mm-hmm. also.
Yeah. Coming up next, we've got Casper for the SNES.
Oh, I'm sure. We got to stop doing 20s cartoons things.
Yeah. Like,
we cannot have that conversation again.
Random.org.
The thing is that people, and that man, that had to come back in the 90s too.
What?
It was like a Casper movie.
Yeah, there was a Casper movie with Bill Pullman or Bill Paxton. I forget which one. Which one was the president?
I don't know. As a goof, we should watch the movie instead of play the game. And we'll talk about the Casper movie because I'm sick of talking about gave y'all platformers based on 20s cartoons.
Yeah. I remember the movie being like super sad because the dad is so obsessed with ghosts. Well, let's not waste it.
Okay. Yeah, we'll talk about it. Yeah, so thanks, everybody. Thanks for listening. And go play some Bad Rats. And don't be Islamophobic.
Umbasa.
Umbasa.